everybody. This is Fred Shellabarger from Sioux City Catholic. I'm the Director of Evangelization and Discipleship for the Diocese of Sioux City, and I just wanted to take a minute to talk to you about the importance of prayer in your work in ministry. So one of the biggest challenges I often encounter in my work and even in my own life in ministry is a lack of prayer. For those of us who have devoted our lives in one way or another to evangelization, discipleship, and catechesis, it can actually become quite easy to take our prayer life for granted. We can find ourselves drifting into apathy and spiritual laziness, oftentimes unintentionally, even while being active in ministry. I think it's because we can give in to the temptation of treating our own spiritual life as work. Suddenly, our own pursuit of growing in holiness, of growing closer to Christ, of spending time in prayer, study, and adoration can start to feel a lot like work. This is understandable because the spiritual life, in one way or another, is literally our work. It's very human to want to leave work at work at the end of the day. Yes, I could go spend time in prayer. I could go read that spiritual reading, but I did that spiritual stuff all day today. Now I just want to scroll on my phone, play a game, or watch another episode of The Office. And I find this is a constant struggle, even in my own life. Sometimes that temptation is more subtle and less extreme than we realize. But over time, it can lead us further away. And before we know it, we are burned out, exhausted, frustrated, and restless. Constantly giving, we have nothing left to give. In ministry, we can become so busy doing the works of God that we neglect the God of works. We can become so busy doing that we forget to be. To be that child of God we are called to be. To spend time with our loving Father, to seek His face, to draw closer to Him. So many of us can be tempted to wear the phrase busy as a badge of honor. But busy is anything but that. If you are too busy to pray, you're too busy. Slow down. St. Francis de Sales said it this way: every one of us needs a half an hour of prayer each day, except when we're busy. Then we need an hour. The easiest thing for us to do is to work as if it all depends upon us. But the opposite is true. The Lord is the author of salvation, and that salvation we are trying so hard to bring to others, we are in need of ourselves. And the deeper our own intimacy with Christ, the more we allow Him to work in and through us in prayer, the better witnesses we can be. But this intimacy is born in intentional prayer. This is why the Church places such a priority on the spiritual life of the catechist. For those of us who feel overwhelmed with things to do, which I'm guessing is the majority of everyone watching this, and certainly myself, I think the key is to be intentional, to make the most of every opportunity. It's important to remember that prayer is vital to our peace and joy and our work and in our daily lives. St. Ignatius of Loyola said, "Keep your soul in peace. Let God work in you. Welcome thoughts that raise your heart to God. Open wide the window of your soul." We also have St. Gregory Nazianzen, who reminds us, one should remember God more frequently than one draws breath. Prayer is vital to our own relationship with Christ. This is at the heart of Pope Francis' invitation to encounter Christ every day. And before him, Pope Benedict XVI said it this way: "I therefore invite you every day to seek the Lord, who wants nothing more than for you to be truly happy. Foster an intense, constant relationship with Him in prayer, and when possible, find suitable moments in your day to be alone in His company. If you do not know how to pray, ask Him to teach you, and ask your Heavenly Mother to pray with you and for you." So what are some simple things that you can do to be more intentional? Spend some time in adoration each week. Begin your week this way. Make sure your plans really are His plans. Make sure you are hearing the Lord's voice, that it's His ministry through you and not merely your own efforts. Pray for your students, pray for your catechists, pray over that calendar that gets so full. Pray over every aspect of your coming week, all your plans. Spend time with the Lord. Also, every day, pray as soon as you wake up. It can be as simple as a morning offering. "Lord, I give you this day. Thank you for another day that I might live and proclaim you to those I meet. May I bring praise and glory to your name in my words, in my thoughts, and in my deeds. May others come to know you through my experiences today. It can also be a prayer that the church gives us, which not only teaches us the language of prayer, but helps us to grow in our relationship with Christ. There are many great apps for your phone that can give your prayer life a boost, and that's been true for me. Yes, your smartphone can actually help you grow closer to Christ if you are intentional about it. The liturgy hours, the rosary, whatever, as soon as you open those eyes, as much as you are able, give the Lord that day. I know my days that begin in prayer always end better than the days that don't. If you are like me and sometimes you wake up in the middle of the night and have trouble getting back to sleep, pray then. You'd be surprised how quickly sleepiness returns when you determine to pray. The reality is, once your morning prayers are completed, the best part of your day is done and everything else is the rest. Another simple prayer that can be helpful: Lord, I will be awfully busy today and I may forget about you, even when I don't mean to. Thank you that you do not forget about me. Another important piece to being intentional is using every moment as an opportunity to pray. Stuck in traffic? Pray. You have a disagreement with someone? Pray the Our Father. Allow those words, "Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us," to work that unforgiveness right out of your day. Take a quick break from the email and pray a memorare. Sitting down for lunch before you pray that meal prayer, how about you ask that server if there's something you could pray for them for? It's noon, why not pray the Angelus? Doing an administrative task that you really don't enjoy? That's always true for me. Okay, offer that up as a prayer for someone or a particular need. Sometimes we make prayer more complicated than it is, and that can lead us to feelings of guilt and shame. To pray is to think lovingly about Jesus. As St. Teresa of Avila said, it's a close sharing between friends. It means taking time frequently to be alone with Him, who we know loves us. Make sure you put some time in each and every day to encounter the love of Christ. The key again is being intentional. Make a decision to pray and stick with it. If you miss one day, fine. Don't beat yourself up with guilt. But don't give up the next day too. The hardest day to pray is the day after you forget to pray. So make the decision now to be intentional, to pray, and to seek His face. From Sioux City Catholic, I'm Fred Shellabarger. Peace be with you.